Greetings. That's part of a song I was working on having to do with the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. I have some projects going where it started out being music, art, and poetry for peace, and it's expanded way beyond that. And so this video has to do with how you can be involved and help if you so choose. This is hopefully a condensed version of another video that I made, in case you have only a limited amount of time to check it out. But anyways, a couple ways that you can help. You can contribute music, art, or poetry, and then I can just share it on the site, or one of the sites. You can also put a little bit of time into it and collaborate in person or over the net on music and poetry and everything. Another way is that you help with editing or website building or website maintenance. Another way is growing trees and or planting them. Another way is, since one of the branches is going to be broadcastingpeace.tv, it's going to be an internet TV station. We're going to have all kinds of videos. It's going to be interviews having to do with conflict resolution, peace, what peace means to people, also organic growing and canning, and I think I said conflict resolution, anything having to do with earth and peace, things that we need. We need to come together and we need to focus on these things. And if you can teach any of those things, share videos, teach on any of those things, or edit or supply any time that you want to put into it, that would be great. Another way that you can help is donate money. A lot of these things are going to take money. With the internet TV station, of course, we can go with like YouTube, and there will be videos on YouTube, but also at the same time, it's going to host its own videos. If we rely upon sources such as YouTube, which are great, but if for some reason YouTube goes down or they decide to take off your content, then it all disappears. And we want this to be as self-sufficient as possible. So there will be redundancy, and a lot of the videos and such will be hosted both on, say, YouTube and broadcastingpeace.tv. That will be, a lot of it will be pre-recorded, and then there will be live content anywhere from interviews to the teaching things to there'll be music related. Hopefully there'll be some concerts and so forth. And I would like to work it into where we can live collaborate over the internet. And that's going to depend on the web hosting and bandwidth and what have you. So that's one of the reasons why we need some donations. I'm willing to pour myself into this as much as humanly possible. If you check out soundslikepeace.org, broadcastingpeace.org, or treesarelife.org, you'll see a lot that's already been set into motion. Those need to be updated quite a bit, but I'm not going to do that until I know exactly how some of this pans out. I've talked with a number of people lately. There are things in the works, and so I'm not going to spend I don't know how many hours revamping the sites and then find out that somebody 2 days later comes along and says, well, I do this for a living. I could make it look very nice, be much more organized and user-friendly, and then I would have wasted all my time updating 2 days before then. So if you go to any of those sites, you'll see that it's obvious that there's already a lot in motion, and I want to really step this up. There are a lot of good peace and earth groups out there. I respect any efforts towards positive change. Many of them have generally the same type of approach as each other, and that's great and that's wonderful. But we need some new visions, ways of looking at the things and bringing everything together. And I look at the projects that I'm involved in as one of the ways that we can bring different groups together and actually complete this web of life that we have, instead of having individual pods that might have common goals but are not necessarily working together in any way or the other. So that's what a lot of it's about. If you do want to talk about any of this, you can go to, probably the best way would be soundslikepeace.org, and just click the contact button. If you do want to donate, it's much appreciated. And there are different ways you can do that, but if you go to soundslikepeace.org and click on the donate button, you'll see a couple different options. And again, you can get a hold of me. And if you can't donate money and you have some poetry, or you have some ideas, or you have some questions, all you need to do is get a hold of me. I'm more than willing to talk to you about this. If you have any ideas, all ideas will be taken in. But a whole bunch of this is already planned, and a lot of it needs help to be set into motion. Help with people putting some time into it, help with the money, help with in a number of ways. And so just contact me with any questions, and I hope to hear from you soon. And if in any way, that if you can't be involved in this directly in any way, just please go off and do something. Plant a tree. Come up with a new approach to helping to enlighten the youth, to empower the youth. There are a lot of kids out there that are doing some great, great, great works towards peace and earth and sustainability. Look around and find one of their projects and put your shoulder behind their work. You know, spread the word for them. Whatever you can do. I want as much help with mine, with this project as possible, but this is not really mine. I shouldn't use that word. This is something I'm helping to organize and enable. And it's my vision, but it doesn't belong to me. It belongs to all of us, and it can only go as far as it can with whatever limited resources that we have, including just time that people put into it. So in one way or the other, please help. Contact me with any questions, and I hope I didn't ramble on too much. I'm mostly over my flu, so most of the fever's gone. I'll talk to you later, and peace and love to you and all. Thank you very much. Peace.